Hello, I'm Sasson Jamshidi with ServiceNow, and I'm a strategic alliance architect with our strategic alliances group. And I've been working for the past few months with Cisco to help develop a DNA plus ServiceNow solution. And with me, I'm very honored to be able to talk here with you, is Alamelu, a part of the DNA engineering group. Alamelu, hi.
Hi. My name is Alamelu Senthilnathan. I've been with Cisco, and I'm a business analyst and project manager. I work on the DNA Center platform team, and I've been helping enable the integration of the DNA Center platform with IT service management systems like ServiceNow.
Yeah, it's been really cool to be able to work on this. Not only have we been able to see the benefits of getting the DNA information directly into ServiceNow tickets, but we're leveraging best practice workflows inside of ServiceNow as well to do it. It's been a really, really cool experience, and I have to give my hat off to Alamelu here. She's put a ton of effort and a ton of work into this. As those watching might know, ServiceNow is all about enterprise workflow and service management, and this is beyond ITSM in most cases. However, in this example, what we're going to be focusing on is the ITOM entry point with event management, as well as incident problem change, one of the most bread and butter things that ServiceNow is able to do. But why was that sort of the place where we saw DNA expanding?
So DNA Center basically is a complete software-based network assurance and automation solution. So over the last year, we've been working on this platform that we're building over DNA, right, that we call the DNA Center platform. So the DNA Center platform basically has a rich API catalog with which you can tap into all the insights available in the network to get a lot of value out of the data that's available in the network. Yeah. It also provides 360-degree integration with a lot of systems like the security system, ITSM, IPAM, and you can leverage the API catalog that's available to get a lot of information from the network, and we integrate it with ITSM systems like ServiceNow so that the information is made available to business more proactively than reactively.
Why don't we take everybody through a few of the sort of configuration options and kind of what that looks like inside of both the DNA platform and ServiceNow.
Yeah.
So what are we looking at here, this beginning page?
Okay, this beginning page, we're basically talking about the DNA Center, where it talks about different links that you can go to provision your network, the details that it has about assurance, and what we're concerned here is about the platform.
Yeah.
This is the DNA Center platform, which basically integrates with ServiceNow, and that has the details about how you configure to talk to an external system and things like that.
Awesome. So taking that a step further, when we are at the point where we're going to be developing a connection point to ServiceNow, what does that look like? What kind of information do we need to provide, and what sort of options do we have?
Okay, so the DNA Center platform basically, if you see here, how we make the whole list of APIs available is that we bundle them based on use cases. So for different use cases, what APIs are available, we bundle them together, and there's a lot of composite APIs that we've built as well to solve business intents.
Right.
So intent specific is the whole thing about DNA. So we bundle these APIs, and we've made them available in My Bundles, and once you activate a bundle, all the APIs available in that bundle gets available under Developer Toolkit. So this is where all the endpoints that you configure to talk to any external system, all those are available.
I see.
So you go to any API that you want to execute, and you provide the necessary configuration. That configuration could be like, what is the ServiceNow URL that you want to connect to, the username, the password.
Such as in the upper right there,
yes,
right?
Exactly.
Okay.
So you provide the instance details of the ServiceNow system you want to connect to, or any REST endpoint system you want to connect to, wherever you want to connect to. And that could also have other configuration-specific details. For example, say you want to synchronize the inventory between DNA and ServiceNow. So ServiceNow mandates certain requirements like, you know, for reporting purposes, from where did the source device come from, and things like that.
You were talking about these bundles earlier. Can you, let's take a look at an example of one of those, and what are some kinds of things that you can configure within one of those bundles? Like, let's say a swim event.
Okay, a swim event, for example, basically swim is software image management.
Yeah.
So this bundle has all the APIs that's necessary to go and look into the network for any devices that has outdated images, pick up all that device information, enrich that information with more network context data,
right,
and provide that information in a format that ServiceNow can consume.
Right. So let's take that a step further, and we'll move into kind of how that manifests in ServiceNow.
Yes.
So as the main entry point, we definitely wanted to make sure that we leveraged a place that can take the volume of raw data that comes in from DNA, especially for large enterprises and large networks, and that is ServiceNow Event Management.
True.
And with that, I guess the primary takeaway here is the fact that if there are duplicate events, if there's flapping, any of sort of raw data, the massive amount of it that can come in, Event Management is the place that where we handle that. And that comes in and gets imported as raw JSON in this case. And so from there, we actually run it through a couple of rules, and that becomes something called an alert. So whenever things come into that alert, this is where we actually are putting some sophistication on the data. We're parsing through it, we're tying it to the CMDB.
That's
actually,
right.
On that note, when it comes to the CMDB, how can you explain a little bit of how a DNA interacts with the ServiceNow CMDB?
So that is also a bundle that we've configured. It's basically, everything is driven through APIs.
Yeah.
So we have APIs in DNA that can go and look at the device inventory, pick up all the device details, package it in a format that can be sent to ServiceNow, that can be consumed by the identification and reconciliation API in ServiceNow.
Right.
And once that's done, so we have some key identifiers to identify every device uniquely, which can vary from system to system. So we use the serial number, host name, and a ton of those details to uniquely identify a device. And like you know better, that the ServiceNow Identification Reconciliation API is capable of handling duplicates.
Yes.
So only new devices or devices that have updates automatically get synchronized into the ServiceNow CMDB.
So after this, this is when we get into the real, I guess to use an expression, meat and potatoes of the whole thing. And this is where we're actually on the incident record itself.
Yes.
So on the incident record, you mentioned earlier about enrichment here. And there's two ways that these things can get enriched. There's the one of them to start out with that we've been talking through this whole event to alert to incident mapping. But what about if a user submits one of these incidents?
So DNA is capable of enriching that as well. So we have a use case where, say, an end user opens an incident in ServiceNow, either calls the help desk or creates an incident himself in ServiceNow, and provides the details that he is aware of, like his network user ID or what category of issue he faces. So what DNA is capable of doing is DNA captures this information, and we can invoke an API in DNA, which with this basic information provided by the user, it probes into the network. And now with DNA Center, instead of the network being a lot of hardware devices combined together, it's basically a single entity where using a software, we can probe into all the details in the network.
That's fantastic.
So we go and get all the enrichment information, like say this network user is connected to these devices. These are the issues that happened on these devices. These are the impacted hosts because of those issues.
Amazing.
What is the neighboring topology of this particular user? Get all that information, package that together and provide back in ServiceNow. So ideally when a ServiceNow network engineer or admin opens that ticket, he is already provided with more information than the basic information provided by the user.
Yeah.
So he can make a much more informed decision. And this saves a lot of time.
Let's say, hypothetically, that this issue now needs to have some sort of adjustment or change in the network. So maybe it could go off and do a root cause investigation. Maybe a problem is created. But in this scenario, what happens when a user needs to make a change to the network in order to solve the problem?
So from a ServiceNow side, we've configured a lot of business rules. If he wants to go and execute a change, and to make it more standardized, we have this concept called runbook.
Yeah.
So if he wants to execute a change, he can just hit on the button to just execute the runbook, and this triggers a call to DNA. And depending on what the use case is, in DNA, we look up at what the end API needs to be called to remediate this action, and we have all the information already, and we go ahead and execute those APIs to remediate the action. So from an end user perspective, irrespective of the problem he's remediating, all that he needs to say is execute the runbook.
So this is really exciting. We're really happy to be able to include a integration between Cisco DNA and ServiceNow. Please be on the lookout at these links to be able to learn a little bit more about it in the coming months and quarters. So thank you very much. I've been Sasson Jamshidi.
Thank you. This is Alamelu Senthilnathan.
And we'll see you guys later.
Bye.